Good morning. Welcome to the forecast discussion for Monday, June 28th, 2021. Of course, I'm your meteorologist, Stephen DiMartino. Well, we have a lot to talk about. Definitely check out the premium discussions as I went into detail about what to expect with the Western drought that's happening right now. Possibly a mega drought might be developing here and how that impacts our region. Definitely a detailed discussion on that in the premium section. And also, the potential for some very heavy rainfall on Thursday, so definitely check that out as a premium member. This morning, it is muggy out. I mean, you can't get more humid than this. Well, I mean, okay, you can. You can be stuck in the 80s, but let's not go there, right? Temperatures range from the lower to mid-70s throughout the region with a southwesterly wind around 5 to 10 miles per hour. There were some areas of fog earlier this morning, but that has lifted, but we still have a lot of mix of sun clouds throughout the region with muggy conditions. Now, here's our radar right now. Not much going on over our neck of the woods. This cold front will eventually make its way through the region, but not until Thursday. And when it does, it's going to be packing quite a bit of rainfall. Now, we have a tropical disturbance down here. It's rapidly heading towards the Georgia coast, but it has the potential of developing into a tropical depression, maybe even a tropical storm before making landfall. It's moving over what we call the Gulf Stream, which is some very warm water. So it has the potential, a slight potential of becoming a named storm here before making landfall. Primary impact along the southeast coast will be heavy rainfall. Meanwhile, our neck of the woods, basically you can see our air mass is coming straight from Bermuda and right into our area, providing that tropical humid weather pattern. On the infrared satellite picture, there is our tropical low right there. You actually see the circulation getting a little bit better organized. This is the Gulf Stream right here, so it's just starting to move over. If it starts to produce convection, or these brighter cloud tops, right over the center, then most likely we'll get the named tropical system out of this. But right now, it looks like enough shear is in place to limit that potential, but we'll keep an eye on it. Meanwhile, as you can see, not much in the way of any type of enhanced cloud cover over our area. Now, what we're going to have to watch out for today, tomorrow, and Wednesday is that with a sea breeze front or maybe like a little, what we call mesoscale boundary, a little trough, that could ignite a thunderstorm or two. But for the most part, it's just going to be sunny, muggy, and uncomfortable out there. And unfortunately, that's going to set up a heat index that's going to be pushing close to 105 in many locations. So if you're outdoors today on through Wednesday, drink plenty of water and try to stay cool as best as possible. If you start feeling hot and overheated, get indoors, get into a cooler location, drink plenty of water, maybe get a wet cloth and put it over your neck and just try to cool down, because these type of conditions, especially if you're not used to them, can really knock you for a loop. As you can see, we have the clouds rotating in from the Atlantic at the mid and lower levels of the atmosphere. The upper levels of the atmosphere are coming in from the southwest. So a mix of sun and clouds and just hazy conditions throughout the region. So let's dive into this forecast for today. Scattered to broken cloud cover is expected this morning, becoming more scattered this afternoon, with a threat for an isolated thunderstorm. Temperatures will range from the lower to mid 80s on the immediate coast, upper 80s to mid 90s away from the coast, and watch out for that heat index, especially in the Philadelphia and New York City metropolitan areas and basically the I-95 corridor. Rinse and repeat the same pattern for Tuesday and Wednesday, with areas of fog possible in the morning, lows in the lower to mid 70s, highs ranging from the mid to upper 80s along the immediate coast, upper 80s to mid 90s away from the coast. If you get that southwesterly wind on the south side of Long Island, you'll stay more in the lower to mid 80s because of the Atlantic Ocean. Thank you very much. Other than that, watch out for an isolated thunderstorm. It's going to be capable of some very heavy downpours, frequent lightning, and some strong wind gusts. Now we get to Thursday, and then things get interesting. We're going to have this cold front slowly drop through the region. And when I mean slowly, I mean it's going to fall through like molasses, okay? So you're going to get these thunderstorms developing in the afternoon, and they're just going to continuously train over the region, which means There is pretty good potential for some very heavy rainfall out of this cold front on Thursday afternoon and evening, and the potential for flash flooding, maybe some wind damage or some of the embedded thunderstorms, frequent lightning. It's not going to be pretty on Thursday. So if you have any plans in the afternoon or evening, you might want to postpone them to the next day because this is not going to be pretty. Temperatures on Thursday will range from the upper 60s to mid 70s for lows. High temperatures will range from the upper 70s to mid 80s over the interior, mid 80s to lower 90s along the coast. Now on Saturday, on Friday, that cold front continues to push south. And then this is the start of the 4th of July weekend, right? So still the threat for a few showers in the morning hours, more so into the afternoon for southern New Jersey, with this cold front slowly pressing down. But the main story in the afternoon and evening will be the transport of drier air. Look for low temperatures to range from the lower to mid 60s over the interior, mid 60s to lower 70s along the coast. High temperatures will range from the lower to mid 70s over the interior, mid to upper 70s along the coast, upper 70s to lower 80s in the Delaware River Valley, specifically around Philadelphia. Then for Saturday, Sunday, and Monday, basically going right through the 4th of July weekend, high pressure will generally be in control. I can't rule out an isolated shower or a pesky shortwave here and there, but for the most part, we're dealing with dry conditions, much lower humidity. We're talking about low temperatures in the mid-50s to lower 60s over the interior, mid-60s along the coast, high temperatures ranging from the mid to upper 70s along the immediate coast, mid-70s to lower 80s over the interior, and upper 70s to mid-80s in the Philadelphia metropolitan area. Far better than mid-90s, I could tell you that. And you could still go and enjoy the beach with dry conditions. So it looks like the 4th of July weekend is looking a lot better. That is your forecast discussion for today. Of course, I'm your meteorologist, Stephen DiMartino. And as always, stay safe out there.